simulators. You either love them or hate them. I don't think that there is a single person who plays Roblox that is indifferent to simulators. I mean, they're everywhere. Every page, every ad, every group. Simulators, simulators, simulators. Maybe it's because they're incredibly easy to make. Or perhaps it's because the attention span of the people who play on this platform is not a whole lot. Whatever the case may be, simulators are everywhere. Most simulator games on Roblox follow the same exact formula. Click on thing.
Wow!
Earn X product. Sell X product to buy upgrades to get and sell X product faster. Pets that allow you to earn Y percent more of product X, and etc, etc. We all know the gist, so let's just get into the meat and potatoes of today's topic. While I may hate simulators with a burning passion, they aren't all bad. Mow My Lawn 2 is a great example of this because this game is the first ever anti-simulator in Roblox. So what do I mean by anti-simulator? Well, it's very simple. Most simulators are completely unironic, giving the player a certain task to do and expecting them to do it. However, Mow My Lawn 2 is different, as it is sort of a meta-commentary on the entire simulator genre. While yes, you still have a task that you must do, that being mowing this guy's lawn forever, it's not so simple. Let me explain. After enough grass has been mowed, a boss fight starts. These boss fights earn you experience points that are used to level up your character. What do these levels do, you ask? Well, you can use these levels that you've earned to enter this nice and unassuming farmhouse next to the lawn. Inside said house, there are a couple of different portals that you can go into. These portals require you to be a certain level to enter them.
Ah, gee, I wonder what this is.
Oh my god! Oh my god! When did this become a game where you're fighting bosses? Yep. This game has mega boss fights. You and some buddies can team up to fight a myriad of different big bad dudes. Toxifier is the only one I've gotten to because I am bad at video games, but I'm sure that the other boss fights are equally good as well. That's another thing about this game. It's very slow to level up, so you're going to be mowing a lot of grass. Thankfully, there are dungeons in the game, because why not? These dungeons just help you level up faster, and they're equally hard, and require a lot of people to do anyway, which is really hard because there are only like 50 people playing the game, and half of them are AFK. But hey, at least there's something to do in this game. It's not just clicking. It's a great bait and switch, and a nice change of pace from normal simulators. The boss fights and progression are seamless, making the player want to keep going to see what comes next. It's a shame that this game is very small and doesn't have a lot of players. I mean, hopefully this video will change that, but I doubt my almost 300 subscriber base, thank you for that by the way, is going to help out a lot. I give Mow My Lawn 2 a 7 out of 10 lampshades. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please subscribe. I want 500 by the end of summer break. That's the goal. I have more ideas for videos than ever, and I want to keep practicing my editing, and it seems that these videos are being made much more efficiently now than a year ago. Another Twisted History soon, as well as some more memes. Anyway, join my Discord down below, and I will see you guys later. Bye-bye.